North and South by Elizabeth Gaskell. Dramatized by Lynn Coughlin. Episode 1.
Margaret? Margaret? Oh, hush, Tony. Margaret?
Yes, Aunt.
Oh, Margaret, there you are. Where are your mother and father?
I'm not yet arrived, Aunt.
Not yet arrived? And Edith is still asleep.
Oh, is there anything I can do, Aunt?
Oh, Tiny! Tiny's upset. Shawls.
Shawls?
Well, I have spared no expense in your dear cousin's trousseau, but she must have all the shawls and Indian scarves that the General gave me, which I will never wear again.
I'll see to them, Aunt.
Oh, and the ladies are waiting and your dear mother not arrived. Tiny, I know there's so much to do.
Well, Edith is very happy, I think.
I so wanted my dear girl to marry for love. Mary! Mary, the door!
Yes, ma'am. Good day, sir.
Good day to you.
Father!
Oh, there you are, Richard.
My dear, and Margaret.
Where's my sister?
I'm afraid she's indisposed.
Indisposed? Oh, Mary, more hot water for the drawing room.
Yes, ma'am.
Is my sister ill?
She sends her apologies.
Father, come and sit down.
Oh, and Mary?
Yes.
Take Miss Edith tea and tell her she is expected in the drawing room, and show Reverend Hale to his room.
I can do that, Aunt.
Absolutely not. Henry is so looking forward to seeing you.
Father, you look tired. Is Mother very unwell?
Don't concern yourself, Margaret. We will speak later.
Of course, I foresaw that Edith was likely to marry early. I was sure she would be married before 19.
My dear brother considers himself a very fortunate man.
Excuse me. Mary, do make sure that Foster has brought up the General's travelling trunk with the brass corners.
And Margaret, whenever I've seen you lately, you've been heavily employed in your cousin's service.
Yes. I wonder if marriage must always be preceded by such a whirlwind.
And after your cousin's wedding, you'll return to Helston?
Yes.
You've lived here a long while, I think.
9 years.
Do you remember your father's house?
Of course. There's a church and a few cottages near it on the green, with roses growing all over them.
You make a pretty picture.
It's not a picture. I'm telling you about Helston as it really is.
Oh, forgive me. Only it sounded like a village in a story rather than real life.
It is like a village in a poem. But I won't try to describe it any more. You would only laugh at me.
Margaret.
Mama! Henry!
Are you well rested, Edith?
Not even slightly. There's so much to do, I feel as weak as a leaf.
Oh, Edith, come and sit down. You look pale. Oh, how I wish your poor mother could have been here, Margaret.
I will be sure to tell her everything, Aunt.
She married your father for love, of course. What else can she have to wish for in the world? Edith, come.
Coming.
Margaret, may I ask to see you? Perhaps after dinner?
To see me?
If you'd be so kind.
Brought you some tea, Father.
Oh, thank you, Margaret.
The drawing room is full of people. Cannot say who half of them are. Come and sit by the fire. Is Mother very ill?
She was concerned about what she might wear.
Oh, poor Mother.
We live so modestly in comparison to your aunt.
But I'm sure Aunt Shaw would have been more than happy to provide her with something.
Of course, but your mother, she must have her dignity.
Yes.
Perhaps it is just as well she's not here. I was going to wait to speak with you, Margaret, but I don't wish to deceive you. I am no longer to be a minister in the Church of England.
Why?
I cannot ignore my doubts.
Doubts? About your faith?
No, not that. I was offered a new position by the bishop.
But, well, that's wonderful.
You don't understand. It would have been necessary for me to make a fresh declaration of my faith. I could not do it.
But why, Father?
One must agree in one's very heart to all the scriptures, every teaching, and to be sincere. I could not.
Oh.
I thought perhaps I could stay quietly in Helston and strangle my conscience, but I found it impossible. We will have to leave.
Oh.
Your mother's home. She gave up so much for me. She might have married a wealthy man.
Well, what does she say?
I'm a poor coward, Margaret. I know so well your mother's life has not been all she hoped, all she had the right to expect. This will be such a blow to her. She must be told, though.
Where are we to go?
To Milton Northern.
But, Father, why? It's so far away.
Your godfather came from there, and he can help me find students. I must earn a living for my family. Margaret, my dear girl, will you tell your mother for me when we are home?
I don't know how I could say such a thing.
Poor Maria, poor Maria. If only I were not married, if I were but myself in the world, how easy it would be. As it is, I have not the courage to tell her.
Father, please, don't worry, please. I will tell her, but when we get home, I will find a way.
Margaret, there you are.
Aunt sent me to find you.
I was just coming.
I expect you're looking forward to the peacefulness of Helston. I'm sorry for not understanding it. I would value any place that you should love.
Even Helston is not always perfect.
You'll leave tomorrow, once the wedding's ended?
Yes.
Will you miss your London friends?
Of course. My aunt will wonder where I am.
Margaret, please. I haven't much to offer, it's true, but there are some prospects, and I do love you, almost in spite of myself. Say something.
I didn't know you cared for me in that way.
Oh, forgive me, I've been too abrupt.
You're my friend, Henry. I could never think of you as anything else.
I'm not a man given to romance, but you have changed me. It's passion which has made me so. But I may hope, may I not? Not yet, I see that, but perhaps in time.
Margaret! Margaret! Captain Lennox is about to sing.
I must go.
Margaret.
Please, Henry, please, let's forget this conversation ever happened. Stay close to me, Mother.
All aboard!
I fear you will catch your death of cold, ma'am.
Mother is well wrapped up, Dixon.
Where is your father?
Such change at our age.
Oh, this is our carriage. I've shown Father where he must collect the tickets. I thought you might have been glad to leave Helston, dearest. You've never been well there.
You can't think the smoky air of a manufacturing town, all chimneys and dirt, would be better than our old home.
Ah, my dears.
Now let us get on board so that we may settle ourselves.
Settle? I shall never be settled again.
Come along, Mother. Hold my arm.
Yes.
Milton Northern. Next stop, Milton Northern.
Look, Father, the sky.
As black as coal. Like a great awful thing about to smother us.
What? What is it?
Nothing, Mother. We should be there soon.
I dreamt we were back in Helston. Oh, Dixon.
Your godfather has assured me he has found us a good house to make our home.
Milton Northern, next stop. Milton Northern.
Richard, what has happened to the light?
This is a great city, Mother. We expected it would look quite different.
Oh, and the smell.
My dears, this is God's parish as well as any other. This is New Street. Bell said that it was the opening up of this place that caused its property to rise so much in value.
Make way! Move on there!
Is it always so busy?
Well, there's many a car leaving the mills at this time of day, sir.
Cover your face with your shawl, ma'am.
Come now, Dixon. There's nothing to fear from the labour of good, honest men.
Except the smoke, sir. The men that rule us from Parliament say it gets in our lungs and clems us, to be sure.
And this is to be our home.
Here we are.
Oh, Richard. Why, it's nothing but a shell.
We hope you enjoyed this preview.
To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.